Khandelwal. I'm a lead engineer and lead technical architect in Jeevansathi. Jeevansathi is part of InfoEdge, which is the parent company of Naukri, Info, Jeevansathi, 99acreandshiksha.com. And I'll take you through the journey of Redis in Jeevansathi, why we implemented Jeevansathi, what is the use cases, what are the different problems we were facing, which were solved by Redis, and the learning and the finding we face, we'll get in the journey of the implementing Redis in Jeevansathi. So Jeevansathi, we have the PHP stack and some monolithic application. So that means the data which we process in each request expire with the request. So in each request, we have to process more and more data which cannot be stored in somewhere. So initially we have the memcache, but we are not storing that much of data because it's just a key value pair. And if we store the process data in JSON value or in the array in the serialized way, anyway we have to get the data and unserialize and do some processing. And so basically all the data comes from we have to get it from the database. And so at the peak time, it's create the high QPS on database. And if the sometime concurrency of the and active users are very high, it does break the application and slow down the application very much. So in the last few years, we are seeing the traffic increasing by 75% year on year, and which is creating more load on SQL servers. So one of the solutions is increase the hardware and increase the database server and distribute the load on different database server. Another solution is introduce a caching layer between database and application, which can solve the problem of database. So we choose this, introduce Redis, and initially as a cache to store the data from, get the data from the database and store the data into the Redis, and for the next request, we serve it from the Redis. So by just doing that, we reduce the SQL query by 66%, and now it's coming from the Redis, the latency is very low, and so we decrease the response time by 16%. And if the response is very, response are getting faster, the users are, tends to spend more time on your website. Also, now we are using different data structure of data Redis, so we are now able to keep process data into the cache, and which also reduce the server processing time significantly. Currently, now we are serving around 2 million requests per second from Redis, and the peak time we managed to serve 7 million requests per minute with the present most of the request in 10 millisecond. Okay, now I'll take you through different problems which you are previously facing in Jeevansathi and the solution how we use Redis to solve those problems. So one of the major use case is in most of the requests in Jeevansathi, you have to either show the data of any users or get the data of logged in users. So in most of the case, we have to get the data previously from the database. And so we choose memcache over Redis because of both are in memory, both are serve the key value, but there is different things which benefit from the Redis. So one is the biggest thing is persistent, the persist durability is persist the data in disk, and if the any instance fails, you can load the data from the disk. And now it's provide you the replication master slave so that you can shift your write to the master and shift your read to the slaves. Okay, and you can add more and more slaves to serve the to distribute the traffic, and it also provide different data structures like hash, set, list. So according to your use case, you can use different data structure and get the benefit from Redis. It's also provide PubSub, also provide the scripting. You can analyze the data into the memory only and get the data, analyze data from the Redis. And yeah. So as I discussed the use case, you have to get the profile data. So in each, so the request rate of the profile data is very high. So in each single request, either we are getting from the logged in user data, or if we do the search, we have to show the data of different profiles, like in the one single request, data of 25 requests, or in the different contact listing, like the interest you have received, the acceptance you have received, you have to get the data from many users. Okay, so request rate of the profile data is very high. Okay, so what we did is, we stored the profile data into hash. So now the data, the hash store is the email ID, name, all the different attributes of the data, like in profile page you have to show hobbies of the user, the horoscope of the user, family details, the contact details, different data. So we are storing all the data into the hash. Why we choose hash? Because the access of any key of hash is order one. Or if you have to manipulate the data of any sub key of the hash, is again in order one. So if you just need the phone number of that particular user, you can simply query the profile ID, user ID, and the phone number, and you get the phone number in just order one request. So the latency reduced very high. So we introduced hash for profile data in July, and we are seeing the traffic increasing continuously, but you can see the SQL query graph reduces as we keep on adding more and more application logic into Redis. Another use case is user dashboard number. So in Jeevan Sathi, we show the different counts of we have to show the interest received count, we have to show the acceptance count, match alert, number of messages that user has received, number of user the user have shortlisted, the visitor alert. So and all these numbers will be shown from the different tables. So if you have to show the different numbers in each request, you have to calculate the data from different tables, process the data, and you have to show the show to the user. So getting the data from different tables take huge amount of time. So and it also creates the extra load on the database. So again, this problem was solved by the hash. So if the user received a new interest, we just increment the subkey of that hash, and again it's in order one. So this is my data structure of the contact data. So for any user, we have to show the interest received, we have interest sent, the new interest received, the new interest sent, acceptance, shortlist, match alert, and all are the subkeys of hash. Okay. So another use case which we used is we have to show the metrics of Jeevan Sathi, how Jeevan Sathi is performing at the real time to the admin team, the product team. So at the real each point of time, how many interests are being served, how many new user logged into the website, how what are the acceptance rate, current acceptance rate. Okay, so for this case we use the PubSub of Redis. So for each event we push the data into the Redis and process accordingly to where we have to show. So if For the historical data, we are storing data into the Elastic Cache. So there is one consumer running which you get the data from the Redis, store into the Elastic. And the another one is to show into the dashboard. So we are using Socket IO to show the real-time score on the dashboard page. So this is the dashboard page. Obviously, I cannot show the numbers, but the historical graphs are coming from Elasticsearch, and we are showing. We are also showing the real-time numbers to the users. So the number of registration happening in the real-time, the logins, interest, acceptance, and you can take the time, take out the time for the which time span you want to see the numbers. Another use case is rate limiting. So for the each application, each service, you have some threshold. So you cannot serve more requests from your threshold. So you have to limit the users from accessing your services. So for that, you can set the counter into the Redis for the either by minute or hour, depending upon your threshold, and manage that counter into you can either use a sorted set, okay, so to time span keep the time span, or you can use a list for the each hours. So you can calculate the count in the list, and according to that you can process the another use case is for the backend users. They tends to get the data for the complete years, and most of the data is in the stored in the SQL server, and taking the data for the whole year from different tables takes some time. Okay, so if the user won't get data into the file, some time they tends to refresh the page, and there's a new request goes, and again they started calculating the data. So we are limiting user from sending the multiple requests, and when we calculate the data, then we started serving to the backend user. Different other use case of Redis which we are using is we have to calculate how many times that profile has been seen by the different users. So according to that, we have to analyze the data. So if we continuously add storing the data into the database, you can see the number of insert which we can put into the database. So we are storing into the Redis, and we have some threshold. After that particular minute, we'll insert the data into the Redis database. We are also doing the response caching. We are tracking the users real time, and we are also storing the session of that particular user. These are the different use case. Now, the infrastructure that we are using of Redis. So we are using the Redis Sentinel because of its high availability. So it's continuously monitoring your master slave instances. So if anything, if the master goes down, it can promote the slave as a master. So it provides you the high availability. Okay. It also notifies the administrator that for any event which is happening on the Redis. It works as an automatic failover, promotes slave the master, and it's also work as a configuration provider. So any client who wants to know which is the current master, it can give you the address of the master. So this is, you can say, the architecture. So we have different Sentinel instances for different modules. So we are providing the master by using HAProxy. So HAProxy continuously monitoring the Redis instances. So it'll check the role, and if the role is master, it will give that will work as a write instance. If the role is a slave, it will work as a read instance. So this is HAProxy sentinel setting. So it will continuously checking the replication of the each instance. So this is for my write instances of Redis. So every time when you request, when you send data to the HAProxy for the write, it will direct redirect it to the mean the master of that particular. So for monitoring, we are using Redis stat for the real-time monitoring. So how it will continuously checking the info of the Redis and give you the real-time monitoring how well your Redis is performing. So what is the current miss rate, what is the hit ratio, number of operations happening each second. For the historical data, we are using Zabbix, and we also have some custom monitoring tools which continuously monitoring the latency, continuously check the Redis, if the Redis has the keys which does not have the expiry set. So now I'll come to the learning and the challenges which we faced while implementing the Redis. Not module, it's a third party tool written on Ruby which continuously ping your Redis and get the info and display into the dashboard.
What is the latency only on single
instance? Not exactly. You can put multiple instances in Redis. You can add as many Redis instances in your Redis stack and it will display the whole combined data and individual data also.
It works on distributed manner. Multiple nodes, it can run on multiple nodes.
Yes, exactly.
What is the real time synchronization between master and slave? If someone is reading and data is still not sent to slave or master, then what will happen?
Normally, it does happen in this millisecond, so the latency of replication is very less. It's normally sync with very fast. So we haven't faced any issue which where the data is set in master and does not available in slave.
Data is stored on the data centers or cloud like AWS or Google?
No, we are hosted platform where it's all the servers are in the same rack. So the latency is some nanoseconds. So the learnings and the challenges. For first and foremost is using Redis as a cache can reduce the response time and also reduce the load on database and server. Using different data types. Again, solve the server processing time problem. Another one is being single-threaded. You does not require any lock, so it's perform give you the asset information. But being single-threaded is a problem. If any request taking a longer time can block your server. So if any request is taking more than 10 milliseconds or 30 milliseconds, if you use the key command, it can block your Redis server. Sentinel cluster can give you a high availability caching server. Another one is the challenge which we faced. If the key space of your Redis instance is very high, then you will find there's large amount of keys which has the expiry set, but does not expire. They're still persist in your Redis instance.
What eviction policy are you using for that?
LRU, simple LRU.
Okay, you're using LRU, but there can be other eviction policy which will take care of.
Yeah, that is possible, but that will comes when your the max limit is exceeded. But if I'm talking about in the terms of where the you are still under the max limit, but still there is huge amount of keys which are present, which has to be expired and has to be deleted. Because how Redis expire in the active mode, there's a frequency set in your Redis configuration, and it will keep on checking keys in the random way. It will pick 20 keys and check if the keys has to be expired, and then it will expire. And if the number of keys are more than 25%, it will repeat these steps. Okay. So by default, this frequency set is 20. That means if the number of keys which has to be expired is, at particular time is very less, so that means in 1 second, it will only pick 200 keys. Okay. And if your key space is very large, so if you have millions of keys in your Redis, and it will picking only 200 keys in 1 second, so you can imagine how much time it will take. So you have to make sure the configuration set is proper in a way that it will pick all the keys. So by default it's set as 10, you can increase up to 500, I guess. There is another problem which we face is now Redis is single core application, and it will only using one core. And if you have a big server which with multiple cores, and if you want to utilize it for some any other application, so that means you are adding more and more clients to that particular server. Okay. And in Redis configuration, your max client set is very limited, and that particular server, the number of clients is more than that that number. So the Redis won't be able to create new connection to the Redis. And even if the max client set is 10,000 and Redis has only 1,000 connection, and the server has more than 10,000 connection, it will block the new connection.
Using pipelining in this case? Because pipelining will reduce number of connections, because in PHP you can't have persistent connections. So
yeah.
you can use pipelining to reduce the number of connections.
Nahin. In PHP you can have persistent connection for the one single request, and for the pipelining also you create the connection for the one single request.
Redis, every time the PHP client makes call to Redis, it will make a new connection to Redis. But if you use pipelining, it will combine a lot of requests in one TCP packet inside.
Yeah, that is fine. But I'm talking about in the one, so Redis, you have different application servers. Each application server will have some of the connection. So suppose you have 900 connection on your Redis server. And there is some other application also running on the same server, which also has connected clients.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. In that case, the file descriptor goes beyond your limit, and if you want to create new connection.
Yes.
Redis is only being run on a single-threaded architecture, right? So, like, when we use higher average machines, basically, of Dell or HP servers, then the rest of the cores are being wasted, basically.
Yes.
So, is there any functionality in Redis where we can run multiple Redis instances over and assign it to different cores? Because we will buy a very expensive machine of quad core, Xenon machine, and then what will happen is that we are using only one core.
But so you can add more and more instances in the same machine.
You keep on adding Redis shards, and then if they create a cluster for those shards, you will use more CPUs.
So you create separate instances of Redis clients, and they will use separate cores. So
what next in Jeevansathi? We are planning to implement Redis cluster. We are moving from Sentinel to cluster, because for Sentinel you have to keep all the data in one single instance, and in Slave also all the data are replicated in the one single instance. So the key space is very huge, and the database which you are using very huge. You have to use one single instance, one single machine to keep all the data, and with increasing when you have to increase the RAM, you have to buy the big server, and it costs you much. But in case of cluster, you can use small machines, distribute the data into the cluster, and you can reduce the cost. We'll be also using Lua script for analyze the data into the Redis instance only. And another one is, so we are started moving application logic into the Redis, and we gain a lot from the using Redis, and we will be moving more and more data into the Redis application logic.